Dear all stress engineers, welcome again to this new appointment with the overview of my book, Computational Structural Engineering. So we left at chapter 4 last time, and now we go into some details of chapter 5, which deals with the instability in the elastic field, of course. This is another problem to the eigenvalues, so to say, so like mode shape analysis, also the extraction of the critical loads is based on the extraction of eigenvalues. Some, in this case, some small theory is given on how a finite element code proceed to calculate the critical loads. This is done using a simple beam example. And then some practical examples are given, like the case of thin cylinders with, let's say, infinitely long, which is not exactly infinitely long, but long enough to get results which are very close to the ones given in some structural handbooks. Here we see the deformed shape of the first mode. Another example is given by a cantilever beam, which in this case is modeled with shell elements and not plane stress or plane strain elements, because we expect this to come out of the plane due to a form of instability, and also in this case we get some good results compared with the theoretical ones. And then again we go for a thin cylinder subjected first of all to pure compression and then to pure torsion. And again, good correlation is found between the theoretical values and the ones obtained with the FE model. Some hints are given on how to take care about the mesh sides, because of course this is more important in this case rather than for natural modes, especially when we expect a deformation like this where we have a lot of, let's say, ups and downs, and so the mesh needs to be quite fine in order to grab this effect. And also here, now it's all, but the next one, chapter 6, is the longest and deals with errors, as you can see here from this page. And we will deal with that in the next days. Ciao!